have value unless it is processed. No raw material has any value unless it is processed. Cassava has no value. The value of cassava is garri. Because if I bring tubers of cassava here, you can't chew it raw. You can imagine someone giving you cassava to chew raw. The value of cassava is garri. And for you to get garri out of cassava, you must grind it. You must process it. The value of wheat is bread. Is it not true?
It
is. Bread. When I give you raw wheat, you won't get any value out of it. The reason why you are passing through what you are passing through is because God wants to process you. And the reason why God is processing you is because God wants you to be your best. Church, am I talking?
Yes.
We like newborn babies, right? If they give you newborn babies, when the mother push out the newborn baby, you will know. No newborn baby is fine until the doctors clean up the baby. If you see a newborn baby that they did not clean, you will vomit. So the body of newborn baby is when the baby is cleaned by the nurse. And after cleaning the baby, you are like, hey, this baby is fine. But when they brought the baby, so the cleaning process is where you are now. And the baby is not very happy when they are cleaning it. You know, they will shout. Sometimes they will slap the baby to shout and become a baby. They will slap and they will clean. And they are cleaning it. They will leave you to be crying. But the doctor will not leave the baby because they know if they don't clean the baby will die. So God is at your cleaning. You are at your cleaning stage. God is cleaning you. That is why you are passing through what you are passing through. So don't complain when you are going through the cleaning process, because that is the process that will make you a human being. Say, I love you. Listen to this. By redemption, we are not mediocres. By redemption, we are destined to be the best in everything we do. Deuteronomy 28, verse 13. Deuteronomy 28, verse 13. And God shall make thee the head and not the tail. And God shall make thee the head and not the what? The tail. And thou shalt be away from you, and thou shalt not be blessed. If that thou hearken unto the commandment of the Lord thy God, which I commanded thee this day, to observe and to do them. Because you are a doer of God's word, you are to be at the top, not at the beneath. You shouldn't be a person that people should come to your community and say, hey, you here. At their entry, they know you are here. That is your inheritance in Christ Jesus. That is what new birth have given to you. The new birth have given that to you. Everyone that wants to make it in life must be strong. But you are strong. There is no man in our kingdom. You must be a strong person. Not just physically strong, but you must be mental strong and spiritual strong. You must develop spiritual muscles. You must. According to the church, he said, success is not final and failure is not final. It is the courage that continues that counts. It is the courage to continue that counts. The courage to continue that counts. You know, most of us have had life no balance. The truth of the matter is this. Life is an equation. Life is an equation. You are the one to balance it. Life no balance. Stay up, no balance, and you leave it like that. You're becoming a mediocre. Actually, life is an equation that needs to be well balanced. You will balance it. And it is what people who have balanced their life equation, that's mine. You are those that should fix this. You are the ones that will make this work. Because life actually is an equation.
Present
that you failed before. Does not mean you are a failure. What makes you a failure is if you give up trying. That you fail and give up trying is what makes you a failure. Because there are many successful people that failed before, and today they are no longer failure. your feeling is a stepping stone to your rising. Feeling is good if you know how to interpret the feeling correctly. Feeling is good if you can interpret it very well. Because there is a lesson to learn in every failure. Say, I hear.
I hear.
Those who don't make mistakes are those who have failed before. Church, I get what I'm
saying?
Any man that has missed opportunity before will never want to miss it again. Church, I get what I'm
saying?
Some persons, some millions of dollars have come their way, they misuse it. I tell you now, they can never miss it again. Because they have learned their own lessons. I see you rising this morning in Jesus' name.
Amen.
But you must rise up and be courageous. Be a man of courage. Don't look at distractions. Refuse to let your setback to keep him on the ground. You must refuse to let your setback to make you remain on the ground. Eh? Our brother Daniel here wrote jump the first time, right? And he didn't make it. I said, I don't have bread. Let's forget about jam and bread. Let me go and let me walk. What happened? He tried again. Praise the Lord.
And
he made it. So many persons fail jam once. They say, one try again. And that's the end. They say, babe, leave it. Don't do that before. He went back again. He did not give up. And now he's a student. That's what you're seeing. Success have friends. Success have friends. Now, are we remembering that he failed at the failure jump before? No. The failure of that jump is not a past tense. What happened now? He is a university student. That's what I say. When you fail and finally make it, people will forget about your failure. Church, I am answering.
Yes, sir.
That is why you should not dare to remember where you are. You can't give up because you fail. Because if you give up in your failure, that failure remains your name. But if you fail and don't give up, that success you have made will claim the failure. I remember saying,
yes, sir.
Buhari failed a lesson many times until Buhari won. So after winning, all those ones he failed, he has praised it. He's not a champion. He's a celebrated president. If you count one of the president, democratically elected president of Nigeria, you mention him. And that is bad for you. Success have many friends, but failure have no friend. People flock around you when you are succeeding. But when you are a failure, people will abandon you. Because success have friends, failure have no friend. That is why you should not dare to fail. When you try a thing and don't succeed, have the courage to try again and again. I want to tell a popular story you know about a man called Abraham Lincoln. Abraham Lincoln was a man that failed many times. Abraham Lincoln failed many times and later became a president of the United States of America. At age 22 years old, Abraham Lincoln failed in business. 1 year later, he ran for legislation and failed. Abraham Lincoln. At 22 years old, he did what? He failed in life. The next year, he failed in business. You see that? Uh-huh. 1 year later, he ran for legislation and lost. When he was 24, he experienced another business failure. At 26, the woman he loved passed away and he suffered a nervous breakdown the other year. See that? At 26, a woman he loved died. The next year, he suffered a nervous breakdown and he has suffered from business failure and have failed. When he tried to become an administration, look at how many failures he failed.
Okay?
He had another breakdown. When he was 29, he lost another political race. At 34, he made unsuccessful run for Congress. At 37, he got elected at Congress, only to be defeated 2 years later. At 46, he lost the bid for Senate. And the next year, he failed in his attempt to become vice president. When he was 49, he was defeated for Senate again. He had four sons. Only one of them lived to adulthood. Others died before their adult. So it was only one that remained. Listen, the man was Mr. Failure, that's his name. But at 51, he contested for US president and won. Look at the one thing about Abraham Lincoln here is that even when he failed, he aimed higher. He failed as a businessman. He went into legislation and he failed. Okay? Rather than keeping quiet, he went and contested for Senate. When he failed for Senate, he went for Senate again and he failed. When he failed, he went for vice president. Look at that. And then you went for president.
Hallelujah.
A man that will never give up will always make it.
Yes.
Each time, look at this, because they have a victory mentality. They don't want to be a failure forever. Instead of being born, maybe as a rank of senior and fail, maybe he would have gone for counselor. Or he might have gone to world chairman. No! After failing president, he went to administration. And after he failed, he went for Senate. After he failed Senate, he went for Senate again. After he failed the Senate, he went for vice president. After he failed vice president, he went for president. And then he passed. And he passed and became the best president, one of the best presidents that America have ever had. You can't talk about the history of America without calling Abraham Lincoln. But he was Mr. Lincoln. And he never gave up. He persisted. Persistency is the gateway to achieving success. Say, I hear.
I hear.
Persistency. He don't give up. He that fight and run away will never come to fight again. And that is it. That is it. Many people would have said, no way. But not for Abraham Lincoln. Abraham Lincoln saw a way where there is no way. And that is it. I told you before, you don't know that there is a way you can move from this zone and get to St. John's until when the lion pursue you. You don't know you can jump a mighty fence until when you are in a precarious world situation. You don't know you can climb a mountain. You don't know you can climb a palm tree without ladder until when you are in a dangerous situation. I tell you. So when the fastest runner is not in the Olympics, do you know where you get fastest runner? When a lion pursue you in the bush, that's where you can go. Praise the Lord.
Hallelujah.
Don't say I am fat. I am fat is not when lion is chased. You don't know a fat woman don't know you can jump until when something to make you jump comes. President,
hallelujah.
Today, no one will talk about Abraham Lincoln's faith again. People know Abraham Lincoln for what? Success. That is how people will remember him for success all the days of your
life.
Don't forget that those who refuse to step on a rock of failure will never climb the ladder of success. I tell it again. Don't forget that those who refuse to step on the rock of failure will never climb the ladder of success. Will never climb the ladder of success. To succeed in life, you always put before you a big picture of who you want to become and fail it. You must have a very big picture. Most of us don't have picture. We don't even have big picture of who we want to be. Who do you want to be? What are your goals? What are your dreams? Carry big dreams. Why you are not succeeding? It's not because there is no goal, because you don't have a dream. You allow the things you see to shape your dream. Never you allow circumstances to shape your dream. Create a circumstances that will shape your dream. Napoleon Hill said, circumstances, I create circumstances that shape my future. I don't allow things around me to shape my future, but I create one that shape my world future. Carry big dream. Carry big what?
Dream.
Don't tell me you have big dream. If I can converse with you, I know persons that have dreams.
A man that have dreams has a way to pray.
The people of a man that have quality dreams, you know. Some people that go to people's house and gossip, they don't have dreams. They don't have dreams. Several times, Oyedepo will be criticized. Is this, is this, is this, is this. If you read it, he said, well, I am not the one to talk about myself. People will talk about me. Because a player in the team can't praise himself. It is the ones watching. Those that make news are the players. The spectators don't make news. Praise the
Lord.
If they want to write, they write Ronaldo. Is it not true? If they want to write, they will write Messi. They will write Osame. They will talk about this playing the ball. They don't talk about those watching. Those watching are noise makers. Because they are ready to say whatever that comes to their mind. Because they are watching and laughing. But it is those that are playing the ball. And you can't be a referee. But many people said, I cannot be a referee. I'm also a player at the same time. Let people that are watching keep talking. Most of us have made ourselves referee in a matter that concerns us. It doesn't work that way. You don't be a whistleblower of yourself. That is why most people don't succeed. People are watching you. Sometimes there are lessons you can learn from those watching. Is it not true? A person dancing, don't know when he's not dancing well. You think you're dancing, but it is those watching that will tell you whether you dance well or not. Two of us. There is a common adage in my community that said the shape of a bad dancer is always with the people. His brethren watching. They are the ones that have the shape. Because a bad dancer most times don't know is dancing rubbish. But the shape of a stupid dancer is always his brethren that are watching him. Because they say, hey, what's in his name? Praise the Lord. I don't know if you have experienced that before. That you are watching your brother doing rubbish. And is doing the rubbish with all seriousness, you will always bring your face down. Even if you say, you don't know what he's doing.
Praise the Lord.
The reason you keep remembering your failure is because your success picture set before you is too small. Or sometimes you don't even have a picture. The reason why people keep remembering their past is because their future is not bright. And for you to have a brighter future, it is you that create it, is it not true? By having set goals, set a nice goal before you and pursue it, you will forget about the past. You will shine. You are created the reward to shine. He said, Isaiah 61, he said, arise, shine, for your light is already come. Rise, shine, because your light is already shining. By redemption, you are created the reward to shine. Anything you are not shining, it is no longer God's fault. It is your own fault that you are not shining. It is not in the hand of God that you are not shining. Because it has given you everything you need, including the grace to shine, has been released unto you. So this morning, you must rise. It is your inheritance. It is your own inheritance in Christ Jesus. If you look at the stars, what makes the star to shine brighter is darkness. It's what? The darkness are surrounding you should make you to shine. In fact, science said the star, the way the star is in the daytime is the same way the star is in the night. Why you don't see the star in the daytime is because of the presence of the Lord, the sun. So, darkness is what makes the star to shine. Darkness in your life should make you to shine. You are created to shine in the midst of your world, darkness. Are you able to understand it? So darkness is not a factor to be redeemed. Darkness is not a factor to be redeemed. It's not true that what is keeping you where you are is powers in your father's house. It's not true. Rather, what is keeping you where you are is the ignorance of the light that you carry. It's not just to carry the light, but being aware of the type of light that you want to carry. You must shine. You must do what? Shining is your primary responsibility. To shine is the responsibility of the believer. Church, if you hear what I'm saying, say, I hear.
I hear.
That's it. Because that can only shine if you don't give up in the midst of your world challenges. Now listen to this, very important. It is your attitude. So it is your attitude that will determine your success in life. It is your word attitude that will determine your success in life. What attitude are you putting on? You must put it up, you must put up a winning attitude. You must put up a winning word attitude like blind performance. Blind performance, they say shut up, he said, oh no. Jesus of Nazareth was passing. And he cried. Jesus, he said, shh. Bible said, before they said he should keep quiet, he shouted yet the more. Until Jesus gave him attention. Listen to me. When you feel that God has abandoned you, reach out to God. If you feel that God is not giving you attention, reach out to him. What are we giving up on you? God will never give up on you, so you don't give up on yourself. Psalm 34, verse 19. Many are the afflictions of the righteous, but the Lord delivered them out of them all. Many, not some, are the afflictions. So a believer will have many afflictions. He did not promise all that the affliction will not come. Then he promised us one, that he will not allow temptation that are bigger than us, okay, to come to us. But even with the one that we can carry that is coming, he has already made a way of our escape. He has made it. So when we anchor in him, we will always be victorious at all times. Church, are you getting what I'm saying?
Yes, sir.
Trials must come. Trials did not come to kill you, but they came to announce you. The trials you are passing through now did not come to kill you. They are coming to bring out the real person out of you. I remember when I told my daughter to hear it was John, because he didn't know the place. I said, let me follow. You know what I mean? As we get there, they lock us outside, no chair, and they carry it. Why did they do that? Because for you to enter university, then he was very young. Does a father write jam for the child? No way. Your jam is your cross, true of us. This is your cross. No students want to write exam, but students want to pass. If there is any government will remove the exam from students, they will, in fact, they will say you are the best president in the world. Students don't like to write exam, but they want to pass. So how will you pass? If you see your children writing exam, they are crying. They are breaking some child. I mean, a child was, you know, thinking of what they didn't know when they get the value. Oh. And he started looking for paper. Nobody wants to see the child like that. But every child must write exam. When you are writing your own exam of life, don't complain. Examination did not come to kill the child, but examination come to make the child a champion. Because without the exam, you won't be promoted. And without promotion, you won't graduate. And without graduating, you will not get job. Praise the Lord. So that is how it is. So when you are passing through your own examination of challenges, do not run. Do not complain. Because it is necessary that you pass through them. Examination did not come to kill the student. Rather, examination comes to another student. Without the examination, the first position of that brilliant child will not be announced. You know, in every exam, they will announce first, second, third. They will not announce first, second, third without exams. And nobody will know who took first, who took second, who took third. Only it's an exam. So the examination is very well good. Temptation is good. That's what I'm trying to say. And prayers and temptation, they are all good. Because they come to announce you. So when you are passing through temptation, don't complain. Church, I have what I'm saying? Yes, sir. You don't complain. You don't give up. You must stand to face it. Yeah. And for the joy, we stood it. And devil thought everything is gone. At the end, what happened? God bless him with 10-7. He needed to have gotten the 10-7 if that temptation did not come.
And Jesus became the King of Kings and Lord of Lords because he had to go to the cross.
Praise the Lord.
If Jesus did not go to the cross, his father wouldn't have made him the King of Kings and Lord of Lords.
Very important.
And his father gave him a name. A wise man once said, don't give up because of one bad chapter in your life. Keep going. Your story doesn't end here. Of course, there may be challenges in your life that went so bad, but you move on. Romans 8:28 said, all things work together for you to better do what?
Work for.
All things, not some things. Work together for good to better do what? Always tell yourself, I can do all things through Christ who strengthens me. There is a man called Asher Edie, you know him. The first Ijaw man that sang indigenous song. That man was the first man, you know, before now, people used to think that anything in the river is mami water. That you cannot use kelu and dance and sing for Jesus. They think that anything river or using kelu to dance or whatever, play in the river is bad. Asher Edie was the only person that made the Niger Delta to start singing using it. That is some he said when he had that dilemma to sing the song, he composed it and went to the uncle to sponsor him. The uncle said, sing the song, said besides your sponsor, then he here. He started singing it. He said, as he said, he said the father laughed and fall down from chair. And said, come and hear. The wife came and the wife told the husband, they laughed and laughed and laughed and called the children. He said, they laughed until the man out of shame left the scene. And the man told himself, I will not give up. My producer said, this music will sell. He started listening people, started meeting people. Never even build your trust on people you know. Sometimes people you know will fail you. I heard him say, if you must make it in life, listen to me carefully. Don't always depend on brother, uncle, sister. Sometimes, Jesus made an illustration. They asked him, who is your neighbor? And Jesus said, a man was going from Jerusalem to Jericho and fall into the hand of armed robbers. And a Jew, his brother, saw him and ran away. He said, a priest, a pastor, saw him and ran away. But a Samaritan, an Abdi, saw him, put him in his house, took him to hospital, treated him and buried him. And Jesus asked them, who then is your neighbor? They said, it is Samaritan. Sometimes, you learn how to avoid those that are not to help you in life. Praise the Lord. He said, he started meeting people. That music that his brother said is nonsense made him to win an international award. Both in US, in London, and in South Africa. That music announced his name. We don't know him before, but now we are known him. Praise the Lord. If we are some of you who have given up. Hey, my brother said to my God, let's kill him again. Let me look for another thing. But he persisted. And today, he is no longer. As a gospel singer, don't give up. Your attitude in the midst of the challenges will determine if you work for your purpose. Never yield to the deception of the devil. Never yield to the deception of the devil. Bible says we are coming to kill, to steal, and the world destroy. When the devil tells you, you cannot make it. Tell him, shut up. Tell him what? Shut up. God uses challenges to bring you. Why Satan uses failure to bring you down if you accept it? God uses challenges to bring you. Satan uses failure to bring you down if you accept it. Remember, you are not a failure until you give up.
Praise the Lord.
Now let me tell you a story about ego. When the ego gave birth, they started nurturing the babies. They protect the baby from the enemies and other things. At the time, when the ego feels that the baby is getting stronger, what happened? It will pick one of them
and climb to a very higher mountain
and leave them.
They will come home and see the man will crash. They will come down and put his back.
They will climb.
They will fly to the highest altitude and throw it away.
I believe at that time, the very evil will be saying, this my mother is wicked.
Because it's a very cheerful experience.
Imagine you that somebody throw you up to a mountain top and leave you. Come back and drop you again. It's not a great experience.
He do that to all the kids.
He do that to all the kids.
After doing it, he enjoyed
doing it.
Why? Because he's training them to be independent, to be independent. God is allowing what you're passing through to come to you because God wants you to be a dependable person. God wants you to be a child he can trust. God is building you up for the battle ahead.
That is why.
So we don't need to give up.
So what the evil, what are you doing? You will do it to all.
After doing this blessing, you will use his feet and tear the nest. After he tears the nest, he will make a noise, fly and fly away. Every other bird that joins him, or only one that joins him is the child. If at the end no one flies with him, you know he don't have a child. Because the evil is not ready to have a for sure child. It's not ready to have a child that cannot soar. It's not ready to have a child that cannot fly. The altitude.
Praise the Lord.
And that is why God don't want to have a Christian that cannot withstand obstacles. A Christian that will cry like an innocent. God don't want them. That is why he wants you to pass through little things. But you know, when you go born again, okay? Most times when a child of God is born again, when you say, God, my wisdom, when you wake up, the wisdom go. You say, God, my wisdom, as he step in, my wisdom. But as you keep praying, God begin to let you know that you have a path to do what to pray. Then when you say, my wisdom, God will say, you say, my God will say, but you know, and I am giving you the grace. You know, Apostle Paul, the same thing happened. There was opposition. He said, I cry, I ate, he said, and there was messengers of Satan. Brother Copeland said, those messengers of Satan tortured him. He said, there were opposition in his ministry. When he's preaching, people will come to oppose him. Praise the Lord.
Allah.
And he said, I have cried times. And God was silent. After much prayer, God said, my grace is sufficient to you. My grace. In other words, what was God trying to tell you? God was trying to say, this year prayer is unnecessary. Come on, I have given you the grace to carry it. Praise the Lord.
Hallelujah.
You see? God was the kind of saying, Apostle Paul, I am wishing to open the eyes of the blind. When the man came to kill me, I didn't love you. In prison, I was with you. Come on. Pray this one out. Come on. You don't need to depend on me. That was what God was telling him. Because we have part to do what to do. In other words, God is telling him, has the opposition stopped your miracles? Come on, come on. That is it. We should be grown up. We should be what?
Grown up. Should be grown up.
The truth is this. No matter the trial or the moment, the challenges will never kill you. No student will write exam, like I said before. But it's the exam that announces students. I want first position, but you must write exams. I want to be a medical doctor, you must write exam. I want to work first class, you must write exams. And it is first class study that brings out first class. Is it not true? For you to become a first class, you must study. It is your first class body that announces you first class. Nobody gives, only in Nigeria, they give somebody who is not a first class. We cannot defend it. It's only in Nigeria that you see a first class that cannot write his name. Especially ladies are mostly first class people in the university. The ladies, we find ladies. May God help this country in Jesus' name. Nothing destroys a nation. I don't know you're listening to me.
A lecturer.
Nothing
destroy a nation than malpractice. Malpractice, if you want to kill any nation, introduce malpractice. Malpractice will make you to have president and government that are not qualified to be there. Because the present generation will soon go away. These children that you are giving to expand and not merit it, they will soon be the governors. And when such ones are the governors, they have nothing to think out. So we will not be serious. We will not be serious. My practice is one of the things killing Nigeria. My practice in schools. And we are taking it very lightly, but it's a serious thing. Bribing lecturers, doing this, to have personal that you did not merit. You present it in a company, the employee you cannot deliver. Having of our personal today is having employment. In those days, companies come when they are awarding personal. If they are awarding personal in uniform anywhere, Shell will come, and people will come to give them immediately. Because they know that first class is first class brain. Because they need first class brain in their country. But now, first class students are no longer first class brain. In fact, they are hundreds brain climbing to first class. Why the first class are the top class? And that is why in any time now they will say, come and show me. Don't tell you what you have. Because they know that the system is what? But not in US, not in other countries. Because here, first class is what? First class. They tell themselves the truth. For a nation, for every individual to rise to the top, you must always tell yourself the truth. Self-deception is very dangerous. Don't deceive yourself.
Church, are you talking?
Yes, sir.
Now, let us consider how to conquer despite your challenges. How to conquer despite your challenges. How to continue to win despite your challenges. Number one, you must change from wrong perception about yourself. You must change from wrong perception about yourself. You must change. The first mountain you have to conquer in your mind is that nobody will ever move forward in life with the wrong mentality about himself. You have a positive mindset. You must have I can do all this mentality. You must have a positive perception. The way you perceive yourself must be right, not wrong.
Church, are we talking?
Yes.
The first thing you need to do is to readjust your mind. Because if you have a wrong perception about yourself, nobody can change you. You must readjust your mind. Judges chapter 6. Judges chapter 6 from verse 11 to 16. Open your Bible, everybody. Judges chapter 6, verse 11 to 16. And I read. If you are there, please, Judges is in the Old Testament, not the New Testament, please. If you go to Matthew, you are looking at Judges. After Joshua. After Genesis, Exodus, Leviticus, Numbers, Joshua, you will see Judges. Are we there now?
Yes.
Come on, if you are there, say I'm there. You must be a Bible scholar. That is it. Elijah said, and there came an angel of the Lord and sat under an ark, which was in Ophrah, that pertained unto Joash, the Abyssinite, and his son Gideon, threshing wheat by the windpress. To hide it from the Midianite, because that time Midianite is in control of them. They committed sin and they announced it to the Midianite. Imagine somebody pressing his wheat and wine and is afraid so that the Midianite will not come and hijack it from them. You must take permission from the Midianite in your own land because they were slaves. 12. And the angel of the Lord appeared unto him and said unto him, the Lord is with thee. You mighty man of valor. 13. And Gideon said unto him, oh my Lord, if the Lord be with us, why then is all this befalling us? And we are doing all his miracles, which our father told us of, saying, did not the Lord bring us up from Egypt? But now the Lord has forsaken us, and delivered us into the hands of the Midianites. 14. And the Lord looked upon me and said, go in this thy might,
and thou shalt save Israel from the hand of the Midianite. Have I not sent thee? 15. And he said unto him, oh
my God, look at that. Look at that.
He said, oh my God, what shall I save Israel? Behold, my father is poor in Manasseh, and I am the least in my father's house. 16. And the Lord said unto him, surely I will be with thee, and thou shalt speak the Midianite as one man. You see, you must see God the way God sees you. This man, God sees him as a mighty man of what? Valor. And he said, I am the least in my father's house. With that kind of mentality, he would cannot achieve what? Success. See yourself the way God sees you. God sees you as the original. He sees you as the light of the world. He sees you as a new beggar. He sees you as a rich man. You must see yourself with dignity that the world has seen you. If not, you will not amount to anything in life. See yourself the way God has seen you through redemption. You are a conqueror. You are doomed to make this happen. See yourself like that from your inner mind. Because it takes a change of attitude and mind for success to come. The same thing happened. So the 12 spies, okay, the 12 spies, sorry, that were sent to spy Jericho. And what happened? Only two persons saw themselves the way God sees them. Others said, we are like grasshopper, which is a lie. We are like grasshopper in their eyes. How did they know? Church, did they enter their eyes? No. He said, we are in their eyes like grasshopper. How did they know? They exaggerated it. It is what they are thinking that they are saying. That they are like grasshopper in the people's hand. Because you know what they were trying to say is that they are like grasshopper in the people's mind. So how did they enter their mind? And know what they were saying, thinking about them. It was because of the fear that entered them that made them to give. And God was against it. God was not angry that the people were not taught or rich. But God was angry for them because they were undermining his power. I get what I'm saying?
Yes, sir.
Church, come on, listen. Because they were undermining God's power. And God was, and God told them, because of this kind of mentality you have, you will not enter the promised land. Now listen to me. No man goes to a war thinking he will not make it, that will make it. For as a man thinketh in his heart, so he is. When you carry defeat mentality, you will be defeated. It is only success mentality that produces what? Success. You are who you are by the way you think. Your life today is as a result of your thought of what? Yesterday. So you must have a positive mindset. You must carry yourself the way God carries you.
Praise the Lord.
Hallelujah. Never you allow the things you see today to weigh you down. Allow what the word of God says to give you up.
That is the truth about you.
Number two, you must avoid no helper consciousness. You must avoid what? No helper consciousness. Everyone say no helper consciousness.
No helper consciousness.
You must not be conscious like the answer I just said here. Okay? If you have one to say, hey, I don't have helper man. You must know what will help me. Let me the last job. After all, must everyone make it? I don't have uncle. Who will give me 1 million? Who will give me 10 million? Who will give you 10 million? It is God that will bring home to you. Praise the Lord. The money you need today is in the hand of somebody. Is it not true? And until God moves through somebody, you will not get it. Eh? The money you need is in the heaven. Hello? The 1 million, 2 million, 1 million you need in your life is in the heaven. It's on the earth here. It's an everyday thing. And you need to connect. You need to do what?
Connect.
And until the connector of all connectors come into your camp and where to help you, you will not get connection.
Praise the Lord.
And as Jesus said, yeah? God is the God of connector of those who don't have connection. John chapter 5, verse 7. John 5, 7. John 5 verse 7. The impotent man answered me, "Sir, I have no man. When the water is troubled to put me in, into the pool, but when I am coming, another step down before me." You see that? Jesus asked, "I want to help you. Should I help you?"
He said, "Hey, you know one thing now? This water here, angels of the Lord come to perform it. And people that are waiters, one thing about me that I don't have anybody to come." Is it what Jesus was asking? Jesus, I want to help you. And you are there telling Jesus how you have nobody. Didn't Jesus know the man don't have anybody? Jesus knows.
So, the issue is that I have nobody have eaten up in my mind.
When you have nobody, Jesus is your somebody. Depending on him, he will find the way for you. In fact, if I don't have anybody, I have Jesus, I have somebody. So, can you hear what I'm saying?
Yes, sir.
Having Jesus means you have all. Nobody will come near you at this your level that you are. It is when you start making that they start coming. If they hear that they are giving you commissioner of this, that's when you will know that even in the northern state, you have a relation there that you don't know. I am telling you. Because we said, I carried you. When your mother gave birth to you, and when the first person to come, I opened this your ear. Did your mother not pray? They will come now. Praise the
Lord.
They say, you stand when you see somebody from nowhere. Are you prepared? Did your mother not tell you that? See, the first soap that they use is the oil they put in your mouth is me. They tell me how you argue him now, whether you are there. And they tell you your mother is no more. They can say anything you want to say. Why? What brought all those ones is because you are becoming more successful. And everyone say,
yes,
let Jesus be your helper. Let Jesus be your
helper.
Look at the Lord and say, never. Allow Jesus.
Allow Jesus.
So become your helper.
You become your helper.
When you don't need any other helper. You may be somebody that they brought an offer. Maybe your father has rejected you. Maybe your father has rejected you. Maybe your brother has rejected you. Maybe you are the one that likes saying the truth and the world don't like truth. Maybe you have told them truth and because they say nothing can come out of you, they have made your truth to rely. Let it not bother you. Continue in your truth. For that your truth shall make you all free. Are you getting what I'm saying?
Yes, sir.
Hey,
hey.
There are people in the community that they, if they are looking for somebody that will say the truth, they say, call her, call him. Because as they come, he will always say the truth. Continue to be that kind of person. Because such people, community hate them. Because if they come, they will always say the word of the truth. It is good to start on the side of truth than to start on the side of what? Lie. Very important. There was a young man called Nick. Called who? Nick. This man was born without hands. He was born without toes. But this man became a multi-millionaire. This man is a motivational speaker. He don't have hand. But if he talk to you here, you start shedding tears. He can talk you. Okay? He can talk you out of poverty and talk you into success. And people pay for it. This man rise up to become a billionaire in dollars in US. He has wife, he has estate, and all the rest of things. So a man that don't have hand can be a billionaire, and you have two hands. A man that don't have toes can be a billionaire, and you have toes. Who will tell you you cannot make it? Come on, look at your neighbor, say you must make it.
You must make it.
By the power in the name of Jesus, I decree and I declare,
I decree and I declare,
you must make it.
You must make it.
There was a young woman called Helen Keller. Helen Keller was born blind. And this woman rose up to become a billionaire. And people begin to ask her, "Madam, we don't see, but you are a billionaire. How?" The woman in reply said, "The worst blindness is the mental blindness. I am physically blind, but I am mentally seeing. Majority of us here can see, but mentally we are blind. May the Lord take away every mental blindness from you in Jesus' name."
Amen.
when you are not where you are, it's because maybe you are mentally blind. You are not seeing what others will see in the next 5 years. We see now, you will see it in the next 5 years. By the time you see it, it's already alerted. That will not be a portion in Jesus' name.
Amen.
You are not a biological accident, brother. You are not a biological accident. No matter how they burn you, even if they burn you out of wedlock, it's not your issue.
Praise the Lord.
You know, mommy and daddy, they were just, you know, playing small children thing, and they burn you. What can I do? That you are born illegitimately does not make you an illegitimate child. Every child that comes to this world is a product of Jehovah. It's a product of who?
Jehovah.
Even a rapier, a woman, it doesn't make a child an illegitimate child. Every child is a responsible child before God. So you see yourself like that. Maybe you are listening to me now. They have said they buy half a brother. They will not give you that. You don't have power. You don't have money. Why they are saying like that? Because you have not started making money. If you become a millionaire, the community will start looking for you. If we say it's not for whom they come now, all the inquiry community will start saying, come, my son, come. Because welcoming is welcoming money. Is it not true? You make yourself valuable. Make yourself valuable. Now listen to me. For you to be valuable, it has to be on the value you kept for yourself. No man can choose value for you than you choose for yourself. You make yourself valuable. Now, the youth, listen to me. If you are here, a member of this church, or listening to the sound of my voice, you must learn what when you go to school. That is how to add value to your physical life. A man, a girl that don't have a hand to work, no matter how fine you are, if you like, shine like the moon, that you don't have handwork, you are a liability to your husband. That one will talk to you anyhow. We'll talk to you, a day will come now. No matter how old you people are, you will exchange words. And the man will call you good for nothing. If not for me, with your job, then you know how far. That's why a woman does not mean that. If not a man, look, you will be a woman that can take care of yourself. When a man knows that without him you can live, they don't treat you anyhow.
Praise the Lord.
I'm not going to be able to do it.